We have to get to this story that everybody is talking about. It's our top story, and it's the tragedy in New Zealand. At this point, at least 49 people were killed at those two mosques in that mass shooting, which sadly had been broadcast live over the internet. Now, the disturbing first-person footage appears to have come from a camera worn by one of the gunmen, and it was streamed on Facebook, which raises questions about the ability of global tech companies to actually block violent content from spreading around the world. Joining us now is Yahoo Finance's Brian Chung and David Austin, professor of management at MIT Sinai. Aral is also a founding partner at Manifest Capital. I got your name wrong there. I apologize. Sinan Aral is joining us from MIT. Sinan, let me start with you.
Sure.
There's always an outcry about tech companies on these issues, but Facebook and YouTube, how could they stop something like this until they're notified that something ungodly is happening?
Well, there's a number of different ways. First, you know, condolences to these families. This is such a horrific thing. It's even more horrific to know that it can be live streamed to the world, which serves the purposes of somebody who's carrying an attack like this out. This raises many questions, including, is Facebook responsible for the content on its platform? If you remember, for the last decade, Facebook has been espousing that it's a pass-through organization, that Section 230 of the Communications Decency Act enables it to not take responsibility for things on its platform. There have been carve-outs, like sex workers and so on, advertising, sex traffic. In cases like this, we have to know what is the harm of the content and what is the value of the free speech in a public square. These types of things can be rooted out by moderators. They could be rooted out by artificial intelligence. They could be rooted out by crowdsourcing flags by users who say, look, this content has appeared. Then they can be taken down automatically. I do believe that Facebook has to be more vigilant about things like this, YouTube and others. And you've seen some changes recently that are moving in that direction.
In this case, however, it took, it took, what, 7 to 9 minutes, something like that, for this content to get down. And what we're talking about in some cases is stuff that's sort of ambiguous. This was not ambiguous, right? You have someone live streaming the fact that they are committing a crime, committing murder, indeed, allegedly, that's what looks like was happening. Why is there that delay? And does Facebook now have a responsibility to come out and address it and explain itself?
7 to 9 minutes, entirely too long. There is no reason why Facebook should take 7 to 9 minutes to take down a video like this or a live stream like this. It should be much quicker, within a minute, within 2 minutes.
Well, Brian, in that regard, though, Facebook in New Zealand is saying that they took it down once the police contacted them. To Anand's point, is it possible for, without AI or these kinds of programs, to actually move faster?
Yeah, well, the challenge is that even a minute or 2 minutes would be too late because of just the contagion of social media, right? I mean, it's not just getting the original post down. It's trying to tackle all the other posts that are then reshared, downloaded in some cases, and then repurposed on other accounts. It's really tough to say we've removed the original video and then say, we can clean our hands and we're good to go now. The issue is that the content moderation system at not just Facebook, but Twitter and these other social media companies is a really structural issue that these companies are still trying to work through. I mean, there are, just horrifying reports about some of these content moderators who have to sit, like their entire jobs are to sit down and watch this type of content over and over again, and some of the mental, illnesses that can be brought from that type of work. And I think that AI is definitely one solution, but technologically, I'm not sure how far we are in terms of being able to get there to a point where we can instantaneously flag violent content and basically remove it.
All right, MIT Professor Sinan Aral, thank you so much for joining us.
Sure.